Good morning. Today we shall start a new chapter, laser. The word laser is an acronym for light amplification by stimulated emission of radiation. Laser is actually a photonic device to produce intense, monochromatic, coherent, and unidirectional beam of light. It is based on the amplification of light by means of stimulated emission of radiation of ions or atoms or molecules. In 1952, Townes, Gordon and Seeger in USA and Basso and Prokhorov in USSR independently suggested the principle for generating and amplifying microwave oscillations based on the concept of stimulated emission. It led to the invention of MASER, that is microwave amplification by stimulated emission of radiation. And this was in 1954. And in 1958, Townes and Shallow and Basso and Prokhorov independently expressed their ideas about extending the MASER concept to optical frequencies, which led to the invention of laser. In 1960, T.H. Mayman of Hughes Research Laboratory fabricated the first laser using a ruby crystal as the amplifier and a flash lamp as energy source, known as ruby laser. After this, a series of lasers were discovered. 1900, Max Planck proposed that light consists of discrete bundles of energy. The amount of energy of each bundle is h nu. These bundles of radiant energy are called quanta. In 1905, Einstein refined the quantum hypothesis of Planck by introducing photon concept. A photon represents the minimum energy units of light. Each photon carries an amount of energy proportional to the frequency of light wave given by E is equal to h nu, where h represents Planck's constant and nu represents frequency. From this equation, we can see that higher the frequency of photon, energy also will be more. The light energy emitted by a source must be an integral multiple of photon energy. Therefore, E is equal to n h nu, where n equal to 1, 2, 3, etc. In an atom, an electron in the ground state is stable and moves continuously in orbit without radiating energy. When the electron receives an amount of energy equal to the difference of energy of ground state and one of the excited state, it absorbs energy and jumps to the excited state. So if the molecule is illuminated with a light of appropriate frequency, nu equal to E2 minus E1 by h, or if we irradiate with a photon of energy h nu equal to E2 minus E1, the electron will jump from lower energy level E1 to upper energy level E2. However, the electron cannot stay in excited state for a long time since it is not stable. So, it will jump back from higher energy level E2 to lower energy level E1. During this transition, it will emit a photon of energy which is equal to E2 minus E1, or frequency E2 minus E1 by h is emitted. Number of atoms or ions or molecules per unit volume in a given energy state is known as population of that state. The population n of an energy level E depends upon temperature, and is given by n equal to e raised to minus e divided by kt. Here, k represents Boltzmann's constant and T the absolute temperature. This equation is known as Boltzmann's equation. At a temperature above 0 degree Kelvin, the atoms or ions or molecules always have some thermal energy, and so they are distributed among the available energy levels according to their energy. At thermal equilibrium, the number of atoms or ions or molecules at each level decreases with increase of energy level. So here consider two energy levels with energy E1 and E2. Here E1 is lower energy level and E2 upper energy level. Therefore, according to Boltzmann distribution, we can see that there will be more number of atoms or ions or molecules in E1 level and less number into this E2 level. If number of this molecules or atoms or ions in lower level represented by N1 and upper by N2, according to this Boltzmann equation, N1 equal to e raised to minus E1 by kT and N2 equal to e raised to minus E2 by kT. And normally N1 will be greater than N2. So this population with more number at lower energy level is known as normal population. Consider two energy levels with energy E1 and E2. Here the number of atoms or molecules or ions in lower energy level E1 is marked as N1 and that of upper energy level is marked as N2. Here we can see that there are more number in upper energy level whereas less number in lower energy level. This type of state where N2 greater than N1 is known as population inversion. This is also known as inverted population, and this is actually a non-equilibrium condition. According to Boltzmann's equation, this N2 greater than N1 is possible when temperature is negative. So this state is also known as negative temperature state. This does not mean that we can attain temperature below absolute zero. This happens because the state of population inversion is a non-equilibrium state and the law is not applicable to this. By continuous supply of energy, we can excite more and more molecules or atoms or ions to this higher energy level. A medium with population inversion is known as active medium. Here, there will be more number of atoms or molecules or ions in higher energy level and less number of molecules or atoms or ions in lower energy level. These medium are suitable for stimulated emission, so they are suitable for light amplification. Even in a medium consisting of different species of atoms, only a small fraction of atoms of particular species are suitable for stimulated emission and laser action. These atoms which cause light amplification are called as active centers. The rest of the medium acts as host and supports active medium. An active medium is thus a medium in which, when excited, reaches a state of population inversion and eventually causes light amplification. The active medium may be solid, a liquid, or a gas. There are three main components for a laser. They are active medium, pump, and optical resonator.